Welcome back. It's still Sports Tonight on Channels Television. We're taking a look at our sporting stories from around the world. We began with table tennis and talk about Segun Terola and the great job he went to do in Kenya. Big time brand ambassador from Nigeria, already taking the job to other parts of Africa. And then we talked about boxing. The guys in the studio, they're saying, look, our administrators are laid back because they know that we have talent in this country. And we're saying, no, don't just discover talent. Take it a bit further. Nurture those talent, monitor them, help them to fulfill their potentials. And that's what the Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame, they're trying to do. They organize a competition at the end of every month, 80th in the monthly edition, and the 8th of the Lagos Governor's Belt. And you know what? They have a partnership with GoTV. The talents from this one that want to go professional, they hand them over to them. Let's listen to Wale Edu. He's the chairman, Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame. He says the objective has been achieved and they want to take it to Africa. Let's listen to him right back. Stay with us.
So we're very happy. The objective of our role, as always, is youth development, giving the young people an opportunity both to participate and also for the crowd. It's full of youngsters who have paid a token amount to come and see their peers in action, showing courage, determination, the result of the discipline and hard work that they have been through, and they're giving them great performances in the boxing ring. And that's what it's all about, youth development through sports, in this case youth development through amateur boxing. We're very happy. His Excellency the Governor of Lagos State is fully represented here. We feel his support, we feel his patronage, and we're happy about that because it's good for the sustainability of this program as well as other sports programs in Lagos.
What have we done differently this year?
Well, this year we have continued to have an international presence. We have boxers from Benin Republic, we have boxers from Togo, and of course we have from our neighbors in Ogun State. We have female boxers on show here, and I think what we've done differently this year is that we are streaming live through Facebook, Instagram and so forth. We have joined the world of social media so people can keep up with the action and they can interact in a live manner, which is the way things are done these days. You know, it's all about partnership. We're partnering with Lagos State Government, we're partnering with Lagos State Amateur Boxing Association, and of course we're partnering with GoTV as the corporate sponsors. And you know, they have GoTV Boxing, which is the professional arm, and they are a professional, they put on professional boxing bouts. But if you look closely, you'll see that we are a feeder. There's a natural continuation between amateur boxing and pro boxing. And so some of the top products of Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame, of Governor's Belt, and of Lagos Saturday Monthly Boxing Show, such as Fijabi, Otto, Riwan, Oladosu, they are all now starring in the professional ranks, earning 1 million naira paydays. And we're very happy about that. That for the youngsters that want to go professional, that feel that they have what it takes, apart from benefiting from everything that amateur boxing and sport in general does for youth, they then go on to earn a very good living from it. And as we all know now, sport is big business.
That's right. What other way to end that talk? Sport is big business, you hear me? And that's why it's heartwarming to know that these guys are amateur boxers, but the Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame, they already have a system that can take them professional. So yeah. Sweet.
There's a synergy. I mean, there's a lot there. I said that they can even take us the whole show talking about it. But you're happy because the production line is intact. You're happy because you're hearing that guys can make a living out of this. Not just even a living, make a career out of boxing. And all the activities that they've put together ensures that that switch from amateur to professional boxing, that switch is seamless. It's easy. If you're ready and you're serious about making boxing your profession, I mean, you get an opportunity like this. It's like that springboard that we're talking about. You get an opportunity like this, you step on it, you take it well.
That's right.
And it puts you
to the next level,
where you need to be. And I'm very, very happy. And that's why I say some federations, some people putting things like this together, you need to speak up.
You know, certainly.
There are guys who would probably will be world beaters tomorrow who don't even know anything about some of this. And that's why I'm very happy that the Governor's Belt, I mean, over the years has continued. They've weathered the storm and they're able to do this. And we've also heard about some of the other tournaments that are going on. And so when you now start saying, oh, these people are not doing anything, I mean, you'll be well advised.
That's right.
When you hear all of these things. But the thing that really gives me joy and makes me happy is that, you know, the little waters are flowing. And I pray that when they all come together, it's going to become a big ocean. And what I really mean is that all of these activities here and there, you know, will flow. And we're beginning to have world beaters. I mean, it just takes one person.
Yeah.
We know what Manny Pacquiao has been able to do for his court, just that one man. It's not about all the other negatives. Manny just changed everything for his country. So I hope that will happen here in Nigeria.
That's it. Yeah, I mean, you struck it right there, because what's the Philippines? How many times do they come on the news, if not for Manny Pacquiao? Serbia and Novak Djokovic.
Yeah.
Usain Bolt and Jamaica and Cosmos. When you see kids like this,
honestly,
it just tells you that the future is looking good.
The future is looking good. I mean, look at these young boys.
And their knowledge of the sport.
Exactly. Look at these young boys. And how would I say it? It is not just about children fighting. It is about the fact that you talked about the knowledge of the sport, the understanding. It's one thing to have a knowledge. It's another thing to understand that same knowledge. And that is just what is happening here. Taking it to the grassroots, like you said, that seamless relationship from the amateur to the professional as well. There's a seamless relationship from the grassroots as well to the amateur to the professional aspect too. I mean, this is a draw.
This is a draw. So both boxers are winners.
This is a draw. I mean, the both of them really. This is it. And this just shows you that there's something fundamentally right with what Lagos State is doing about sports in this state. I mean, sports in every aspect, whether it's in boxing or it's in athletics or it's in football. Sport has just, there's a structure already, and that structure, whatever government comes in the next 20-40 years, that structure is still going to be there. It will only be enhanced. That's and right. That is just what is happening right there. And honestly, I'm going to give kudos to whoever is in charge of this, and especially the Lagos State government, for, you know, giving that enabling environment. And that's what we're talking about, that the sport ministry too should create an enabling environment for sport to thrive in Nigeria. And I think that is the best way to go.
That's the best way to go. Totally. Heartwarming right there, seeing those kids. I'm already going through the basics. You need to see their leg movement. You need to see the way they program the left hook before they let go of it. And it's just so sweet right there. Big ups to the Lagos Boxing Hall of Fame. We just want to wish them all the best. Stay focused and keep doing good things with our boxing. Yeah, I mean, let's get on with the show now. Sunday Oli said didn't particularly live the way we wanted him to, particularly with the sort of unveiling
he got
the top expectation, the African
Pep Guardiola.
When this news broke that is going to a Dutch second division side, I said it's good for our football because our coaches are going to get international, you know, exposure. Daniel Amokachi is in Finland.
Yep.
Sunday Oli said, now I'm going to take up a club. And when you take on clubs, it's a long-term thing. You learn so much.
You can say anything about Sunday Oli. You can't argue with his credentials.
Mm-hmm.
You can't argue with the way he's positioned himself. You can't argue with his knowledge of the game.
That's right.
I do have my reservation about his attitude. But who is asking me anyway? but you can't argue with that. And I'm very happy for him. I mean, I've talked about the key thing here is his positioning. And he's been able to leverage on his knowledge of the game. He has improved himself so much. When you hear him talk about the game, you know that he really, really knows the game. And you see, you can't judge a person when he's not been given a fair chance.
That's right.
Now he gets a fair chance. Even, we've not had success. We've not had success in that area. We've seen a great number of African players go to Europe, do well. But in terms of
coaching.
No. And now he gets his, Samuel Eto'o had, you know, played with one or two opportunities. Not really much has come out of that. Now Olise gets, he's played in Holland before, played for Ajax. Now he goes to Fortuna Sittard, a club that was founded 48 years ago. and they got down into the second division, I think in 2005, thereabout. But they do have issues with finances. That must be said. And I hope that will not affect Sunday Olise. But whichever way you look at it, it's a good thing for us. I'm particularly not happy when ex-internationals scrap fight over the national team job. I mean, you can get better.
That's right.
I understand that the odds are stacked up against them because they come from this part of the world, but with determination and perseverance, you upgrade yourself. You have all the requirements, and the fact that these guys have contacts.
That's right.
Now he has this job. Those guys have been having issues with bankruptcy for four or five years now, but I'm hoping that we have enough money to pay Sunday Olise. Well, I also know that they've been able to produce star players in times past. Former Dutch captain Van Bommel was from there. Wilfred Bommer at some point played for this club. I wish Sunday all the best. That's all I can say.
Same here. And Cosmos, our coaches, this is good motivation for them. Go enhance yourself, learn the current trends in coaching, and who knows, someday you might just be heading a top division side.
I mean, you're just spot on about that. I mean, I was very happy when I heard that Daniel Amokachi was making wave in the Finnish league, in the Finnish first division league. And of course, Sunday Olise Tracing, as far as I'm concerned, I felt that that job with the Super Eagles of Nigeria was way too early. I mean, I felt that they should have caught his teeth with some top, I wouldn't say top clubs, but then clubs in Europe, maybe in Africa, but then club football before he came to the national team. And of course, for Fortuna Sittard, they have a new owner, a Turkish owner, and the money is there and all that. And that's why they were able to get him. They actually got him on an 18-month deal with an extension of another year if it does well. So let's just hope that things work well for him. But as far as I'm concerned, I feel that the African coaches, especially Nigerian coaches, ex-internationals, are fighting to make sure that they coach some of the national teams, you know, pretty much should go out there to so high. I know George Finidi at some point was the football director of
Real Betis.
And of course, we've got coaches as well that can actually do well. For me, I feel that Emmanuel Amokachi Emmanuel Amunike should actually go out there. One of a FIFA licensed coach should actually go out there to, you know, get something as well. We have a Mike Menelo that is a football director in Chelsea. Hopefully, I mean, this, for me, Nigerian coaches have prospects. We just for them to get the opportunities and to make sure that they open their hearts to get the opportunities. And I hope that this will, you know, open doors for more African coaches to be able to show what they can get. I feel that Samson Siasia too can be able to get a good job too if he puts his mind to it. So good luck to Sunday Olise, and hopefully his temperament will not affect the job. It's all about the temperament. It will not affect the job.
Sometimes again, it's all about the results. Well, yeah, I mean, there's something about this 1994 class. Mike Emenalo doing well at Chelsea, holds an influential position. He mentioned Finidi George doing so well. Sunday Olise now with this. We know of Daniel Amokachi. There's also Emmanuel Amunike. There's something they are doing that they can pass to the other guys, so that you said something about the odds not favoring them, but it's all about education, so that the other guys can also get into the mix.
Yeah, when you're playing football, it's not about the money. I think that's what they should pass on to the next generation. He talked about Olise, that I'm making a silent prayer that what Keshi's career turned out to be for the other guys, Olise's opportunity to probably shoot. Because Keshi's career, how well he grabbed this opportunity, turned out to be an open door for not just Nigerian players, African players. And I'm looking at this, Sunday Olise, grabbing this opportunity. If he does well, he opens the door, because they will not ignore. Now he has the licenses, he has all the coaching, he has the coaching badges, and his experience, that is why he's being considered. If he does well, other people that are in that category will be considered. If he doesn't do well, people will ignore your badges and whatever and all that. Those guys in the 94, that era, they were privileged. They worked at hand everything that they got. But I feel that everything favors them, and they still have a lot in spite of ending their, you know, playing careers. Mm. They still have a lot to give to Nigeria and to give to the younger ones, because they are the most exposed. That I see, they are the most exposed. They have their contacts. I mean, they achieved a lot, and even that explains why someone like Sunday Olise, you look at all the clubs that he has played for, all the contacts that he will have, and all those things. All of those things, worked together and brought about this opportunity. Mm. And I'm also hoping that while they are making progress in their, you know, careers too, they'll spare a thought for the country.
Yes, right.
And see how they can help the NFL, not necessarily seeking for a job.
Yeah.
You know, not everybody's going to be a coach. Mm. Being a good player doesn't translate to being a good coach.
Transform knowledge.
You know, just look at ways you could help. You could be a good administrator. I mean, it could be maybe your relationship. I know someone like Peter Rafa has a good relationship with some guys in Spain, Holland, some places. All of those things.
Mutia Adepoju is country manager for the La Liga.
Yeah, exactly.
You could use all of those things. Mutia Adepoju has been doing that for the NPFL. All of those things. We still have a lot that we can tap into from that, you know, that squad.
Totally agree with you. I remember you can be part of the discussion on our Twitter handle. We have asked you, what are the ways you think Nigeria can sustain talents that we have discovered? We promise to read your comments on the show. Let's do just that. Chinedu Echeanu says, the private sector, very, very important. The private sector must invest in taking care of athletes. Sports federations must be transparent in their dealings to attract such investments.
Pretty much. I mean, pretty much that's some of the things we've been talking
Everything
about.
Everything that we have said hangs on those two things.
I mean, the private sector and, of course, transparency in their dealings and everything. Trust me, sport is big business. So they can be able to get it. So it's pretty much said it all. And hopefully the power that be is listening.
That's right. So that's it. We'll go on a quick break now. When we come back, we'll take more comments. And then we'll talk about the 2017 African Cup of Nations. Don't go anywhere. Stay with us.